Hi guys, thanks for joining me. This is my very first little tutorial that I've popped together as I've been asked a few times how I make my ratty feet. I've also created a little kit which will be available in my Etsy shop, and it has all the materials in it that you need to make two sets of these feet, so that's 8 feet in total. I will pop a link in the description box below. You can of course use all of your own materials, and I have also popped a list of everything that I've used in the box below as well. There's next to no felting in creating these feet. The techniques that you will use are wrapping and waxing, along with some armature creation. Although this is for the creation of ratty feet, the principles and techniques can be applied and adapted to make a number of different types of feet. Another great resource for this is the Serafina Tiny Toes tutorial on YouTube. So, let's get started making our feet. First off, let's talk about the materials that you'll need to create the ratty feet. Also, what is contained in the kit if you choose to go that route. In the realistic ratty feet kit, you'll find two types of wires, a 22 and a 24 gauge. You'll need one of each of these wires to make 1 foot, and there are enough in the kit for you to make 8 feet. That's two sets of feet with a couple of spares. There's around 10 grams of wool. I use a flesh coloured merino, roving, or I think sometimes they're called tops. This means that all the fibres are running the same way, and the length of these fibres is perfect for wrapping. You can, of course, use any type of wool you want, but I find it more difficult to wrap with shorter fibres or carded bats. Finally, you'll get about 20 grams of white beeswax pellets. You can use natural beeswax, but this does have a yellow colour to it, so it will tint your work slightly. And I use pellets because they're quicker to melt. Next, we're going to be going through the additional equipment that you're going to need to help you make these feet. This equipment is not supplied in the kit, so you will need to source it. Pliers. I like flat nose pliers for creating these, but any will do. These were part of a cheap little set that I bought from Hobbycraft for around £10. A wax melter pot, or some kind of arrangement to melt wax. There are various types of these. This one is a Glade wax melter and is an electric powered. You could use an oil burner with a tea light. That would also work, but obviously then you are working with a naked flame. Just as a bonus little tip, if you're using different coloured waxes, for example, if I were going to make black claws, I could use black dyed beeswax on top of black wool. Rather than having to keep cleaning out this little dish on the top here, you could use tea light cases. These are slightly larger than the normal size ones. I got these from Poundland and they were about 6 in a pack. All you need to do with these is pull the original wax tea light out and you're left with this rather nice little case. That way you can melt your wax, and then when you're done you can change it for a different colour and then just let it solidify, and then you've got your waxes ready for your next project. Obviously do be aware that these cases will get hot when they're on your melter. Okay, moving on. An artist's spatula or mixing tool, palette tool. I'm not entirely sure what the correct name for this is. This was part of a set that I got from eBay. You don't have to have one of these. This is purely for scooping out some wax and applying it to specific places on our project. So anything that you can do that with will be perfect for making these feet. A sculpting tool. Again, got to love eBay. This was again part of a set. They come in various different mediums. You can get plastic tools, wood tools. I like the metal ones because they can be warmed up slightly and will help create indentations into already solidified wax. This is one of my favorite ones as it's got this sharp end here. And then the other end is a nice rounded, blunt shape. Finally, I have a little jig that I use for helping me make consistent sizes. Mine is just a flat piece of metal that has steps cut in it for different sizes, but this can be anything that you can use for making these. The toes that we will be making will use the smallest width on this jig, which is 10 mil or 1 centimeter. Anything around this size will do. I've got a pair of scissors here, and about 10 mil is around here on the scissors. So you could use something like this. Anything that you've got lying around to help you make your consistent sizes will work. That's about it for the tools and materials. So let's get started creating our ratty feet. Rats have two types of feet. Let me get a little work in progress in here. The front feet have four toes and are smaller. The back feet have five toes and are slightly longer. We make the feet in pairs, so the front feet match each other and the back feet match each other. To make a front foot, you're going to need one of your 22 gauge wires. The wire gauges are like needle sizes in that the higher the number, the thinner the wire or needle. The 22 forms the main foot loop of the foot and provides your structure. Fold your wire in half like this, and then I'm going to use a standard Bic pen, and around the main shaft of the pen just wrap the wire so that it's around there. Give yourself one good twist. See, that forms a nice little loop. Then, and the emphasis is on loosely, just loosely twist the wires together. Now, I work with a teardrop type shape for the foot rather than a round shape. So just pop the end of the pen in, give it a bit of a tug, and you see how that just elongates the circle and gives you a nicer foot shape. So we're going to do that again. Another 22 gauge wire. Fold it in half. Get your pen. Wrap the wires around so that you've got a good circle. One good twist on the pen to lock it in place. And then again, loosely, just twist the rest of the wires together. And let's just put our pen in. So there, that's the main foot loops done for the front feet. Both consistent size, nice shape. And we've made the front main foot loops. If you want to be as precise as possible, you could create little marks on your main foot loop where you want the toes to be. You don't have to do this. It just may be a little tip. If you want to get it consistent, you can transfer the marks onto both loops. Okay, so forming the toes, you're going to take one of your 24 gauge wires, that's the thinner ones, and you're going to bring it through the loop and up the main sort of stem, just about an inch, and then wrap it around so it creates an anchor. First toe, with the front feet, which is what we're making here, the four toes are spread quite evenly across the top of the foot. So place the wire roughly where you want the first toe to be, bring it back on itself and come back through underneath. So if you see, I'm coming back through but underneath. Bring your wire through, pull it most of the way through, and then get your little jig or assistant, pop it against your foot loop and just pull the wire tightly. This can be a little fiddly, so pull it through. So you've got it nice on the loop there. Remove the assistant, replace where you want the toe to be. Then grab your pliers and right at the foot loop, make a twist. So that's going to hold it in place there. And then twist evenly to form your first toe. You don't want to twist this too tight, because the tighter you twist this, the more rigid it's going to be. And if you want to put crooks and claws and things into the shape of your toe, then you want to be able to manipulate it a little bit. So squish the tip, because we don't want a loop at the end. And there you have your first little toe. This will move around until you get them all in, so don't be too precious about it to start with. You've also got a few extra wires in your kit as well, so you can practice with this. It's important to point out that the tighter you twist this, the shorter this toe will become as well. So that's a good thing if you perhaps want one toe to be ever so slightly longer than the others. It gives you a little bit of manipulation in the length of the toe or the finger if you're making hands, for example. So just keep that in mind. I've squished my loop somewhat, so I'm just going to even that out. Okay, so that's the first toe. Once you've done the first one, then we go on to the second. So we're going to bring the wire across. Let's hold that toe over there. Bring the wire across. Bring it back through and underneath. So difficult to hold this and get a good camera shot. So let me just see what I can do. Bring it back and underneath. Feed it through, pull it most of the way, get your little jig, pull it nice and tight, and again, one tight twist at the loop. Toe number two. And again, you've still got movement around your foot loop here, so nothing's set in stone yet. Don't worry if they're a little bit out of place. Third toe, same again. I'm going to take it across, bring the wire back underneath and behind. See if I can get another shot on the close-up. So you're bringing it back through and behind here. Pull it all the way through, or part of the way through, and then finish off around your little jig. face, give it a twist. There we go, three down, one to go. So wire over, bring it back through to the side, pull it most of the way through. Pull it on your jig. Place your toe where you want it to be. Give it a twist. And squish down the end on the toe because you don't want loops at the end. So that's four toes across the top there. Then you've got this extra wire, and this is basically now where everything comes together. You've still got a little bit of movement around your main toe loop, so pop your toes where you need them. Then take your wire and just loosely wrap it around up the main stem of the wire. There you go. There's a little foot, front foot, four toes. And obviously you can scale these up and down to suit your size of project. These are just the sizes that I make. My rats are generally the same size, give or take a centimeter or two. So these are the sizes that I use. But you can play with obviously different sizes of jig to form different sizes of toes, different sizes of pens, or dowels are another thing that you can use. Anything to give you a consistent main foot loop size. So that's the front foot. You're going to do that again. So you've got two matching pairs. So you've got a matching pair of 2 feet. And then we're going to come back and create the back feet. Okay, onto the back feet. The back feet are slightly larger, so the loop that we're going to make is going to be larger. So we get our faithful and trusty Bic pen again. To make the front foot, we went around the main part of the shaft. For the back foot, we're actually going to go around the lid, including this sort of bulbous bit. So fold your wire in half. Then go around this big part of the pen lid. Give it a tight twist. And then loosely, again, very loosely, up the main stem. And because we want that teardrop shape again, I'm just going to put the pen tip in, give it a bit of a pull, and that just elongates that loop at the end there. Okay, we'll do that again. So in half, around the lid, a couple of good twists, and then loose all the way up the stem. Elongate the loop. There we have it. Two back feet loops. I see how here this one is ever so slightly bigger than that one. It's not a problem. Just put this around our pen. Take our pliers and we're just going to give it an extra twist just to reduce down that loop size ever so slightly. Let's just elongate it. And now they're a much better size match. So don't worry if you do one that is slightly bigger than the other, because you can always reduce the loop size by just adding in a tiny little extra twist at the top there. Toes for the back feet. There are 5 toes, as we said before. Your first toe is, you see, it's quite low down here, and then we've got 4 more that kind of arch around the top there. So in order to do this, it's exactly the same way as we made the front foot. We're just making 5 toes instead of 4, and one of them is going to be slightly lower down on the loop. So again, we start by creating our anchor, go back through the loop about an inch or so, and then just twist round to form that anchor. So first toe, quite low down on the loop, so as before, bring the wire across, loop it back round and come underneath that first wire, pull it most of the way through. A little jig, hold it next to the foot loop and pull the wire through. Bring in your pliers. First twist right up against that loop, and then twist all the way out to the tip. I twist this little claw a bit tighter than the others. If you remember, I said if you twist a little tighter, the toe will be slightly shorter, and this low down claw is generally a little bit shorter than the others. So give it a few extra twists, just make that a little bit tighter. And now we just go back in and do exactly the same for the 4 top claws. So wire up to the top, come back in underneath, pull it most of the way through. Pull it around your jig. First twist tight up against the foot loop, and then create those toes. And repeat that for 3 more toes. By bringing it around and underneath, you'll create, it kind of locks, helps lock that wire. So bring it over through there. I do particularly like using the florist wires. These are white paper wrapped, but they come in all different varieties. You can get them in green or just plain. But I like florist wires because they're annealed, so you can pull them around, bend them and shape them quite a bit, and they don't break. The florist wires that I use are 12 inches long. I know you can get some that are longer, but I base a lot of my armatures and sections of armature on these 12 inch wires. So tone number 4. Twist. Make sure you squish out the loop at the end because you don't want a bulbous end to your little toe. And finally, tone number 5. Do persevere with these. They are fiddly, but well worth it. There you go. So, number 5. Okay, looks a little bit more like a hand. And to finish off, spend a second getting your toe placement. If you suddenly decide, oh my gosh, they're all completely out of place, they're all far too round this way, you can undo your anchor wire here, and that will give you a little bit of extra. See, I can move them all the way around. So if you suddenly think, oh my gosh, everything's moved, just undo your anchor wire. That just loosens up all of the toes. Put it where you need it. Wrap that anchor wire back in place. And then to finish off, just give a loose wrap on your long end. So, there we have our back foot. And you're going to do this again, as am I, but I'm going to do it off camera. So, front foot with 4 toes, back foot with 5 toes. It's worth pointing out at this particular juncture that you will do a right hand and a left hand foot for the back. This little toe here that sticks out down below, this one goes on the inside of your foot, so when we come to wrap them, we'll be making sure that we have one that faces this way and one that faces that way, but we will cover that when we start the wrapping. Okay, so that's your armatures done. You're going to go and make another one of these, and I will go and warm up the wax and get that melted. I'll see you back here shortly. So we're going to begin wrapping. I've got one of my little front feet armatures here. My wax is nice and melted, and I've got a little protective heat mat under there. I've also put myself down a little bit of greaseproof paper because I do tend to make an epic mess when I'm doing this. So get your wool top or roving, and then you just want to pull off a real small real small amount. You don't want anything too much or too bulky. These are very small toes, and you can always add more on. Trying to remove it is always becomes more complicated. So take your end and just wrap it a couple of times around the base of the stem or at the heel. When you're wrapping, don't hold and go round like this, because you will start twisting your wool. What you want to be doing is taking a very small amount, holding it between your fingers, and then as you come round, so you're always laying it down flat, you're not holding it and twisting it, so always keeping the wool flat like this. So you've got yourself a little bit of an anchor, and let's just move these other toes out of the way, because we're going to start on this one. Let's get a little bit of a close-up. And take your wool, and again keeping it flat, just wrap it up almost to the end. See how I've still got a little bit of wire stuck out there? We're just going to touch that little bit of wire into the wax. You get a tiny little blob on the end there. That's just going to help grab that bit of wool at the end. And then over and back. So we're going to be angling back, coming back down the toe until we get to the bottom. Bring it off and hold it to the side there like that. So we've got a nice, let's get a close up, a nice little wrap. Now we're going to apply wax to this toe. So we're going to dip the wax. We're not going to dunk the whole toe. If you get too much wax, then you're just going to end up with a great big blob. So we are going to touch it on the end like that. It's just a tiny drop of wax. Give yourself a few seconds, because it is really hot, unless you have asbestos fingers like me. And then you're just going to pinch and twist and work that into the toe. I think I knocked my camera slightly. There we go. So you've just worked the wax into the toe like that. And if you've got enough, then go round. I'm not sure I've got enough to wrap another toe here. Might be a little too thin. Yeah. So with that, just going to take that out of the way. Just wrap it up the stem ever so slightly. Any residual wax that you have on your fingers will just help clamp that down there. We're not too worried about this at the moment. It's just the toes that we're trying to get in place. Take another little bit of wool. Repeat the process, just once around the ankle, up to the toe, and you can move these other toes out of the way, and wrap flat until you get quite close to the end. Just touch in the wax, just to grab at the end, and then angle it back, come back down the toe, and hold your wool. I'm just going to get a little blob of wax on the end, give it a few seconds, and work the wax into the wall. And I am pinching quite tightly, but I'm going the same, I am twisting the same way that I wrapped. If you wrap this way and then twist your wax in that way, you're going to unravel. And you don't want to put too much pressure down the toe. So when you're twisting, you're not twisting and pushing this way too hard. Work it down, but don't push it too far that way, otherwise your wire is going to come out the end. So let's bring that down. Just pinch that around the stem to get it out of the way. Okay, two does done. I'm not going to jinx it by going, I'm really not making much of a mess at the moment. Otherwise, the next thing I know, I will upend my pot of wax. Okay, so round the ankle, up to the toe. Almost to the end. Hold it in place. Little dot. Just to secure the end, and then wrap back down. We're going to just get a dunk of wax on the end. And then just work it into the toe. And you are, you can see it on my fingers, you're going to make a mess. I have enough on here for the next one. Little dot. Right back down. Going to dunk it a little more. Okay, so that's the toes. Let's bring all of the ends down. Just stretch them off. Don't wrap too much around here at the moment because you don't want too much bulk. We're just concentrating on the toes. There's a good amount of working time with beeswax, and the heat from your hands keeps it somewhat subtle, supple. Okay, so toes. Right, so that's the toe part. Next, we're going to work on creation of the main part of the foot. We're going to get another bit of wool. Again, not too much. You can always add more. Bring that out. And again, a wrap once around the ankle. And now what we're going to do is we're just going to fill in and cover up these wires. So you can even just poke a toe through. And do pay attention to both sides. And again, always wrapping flat. and then bring it back down the stem and use any residual wax on your hands just to tame the frizz down here. So as you can see, it's just wrapped quite loosely. You know, it's not really tight, but you can't see any of the wires. We're going to get another bit of wool. This bit's going to be slightly wider, but again, not much. You can see there's not much there. What we're going to do with this is you're going to hold it lengthways so the fibres are running towards your toes. Hold it here, and then we're just going to poke the toes through. So do that again. Just going to poke the toes through and then bring it back down the other side like that. And I'm going to need a little more. So sticky. So a little bit more. And again, just hold it here, bring it up and just poke the toes through. Which kind of looks a little like a Yeti hand now. But there is method in my madness. So pull it down so you've got this fur running this way. And then twist at the ankle. It's actually got quite a build up of wool, so I'm just going to pull some of this off very gently. And redistribute. There's no right way or wrong way to do this. I'm making quite the pig's ear of this, so let's pull that back off. It's sticking to my hands. Let's try this again. So holding, just poke the toe through, pull off any loose fibres. That's too thick. We want a toe poking through a few of the fibres. That's better. Okay. Now comes the really messy part. What we're going to have to do is cover this with some wax. So we have a spatula, or you may be using a little spoon or something to basically scoop some of the wax out of there and put it onto there. One thing that we can do is dip a little. This is a bit of a trial and error, because you don't want to dunk the whole thing. If you dunk it, you are just going to end up with a block of wax, and you don't want that. That's not to say that if there isn't a little excessive wax on your project, you can't get it off. You can. We'll go through that a little bit later, but we're going to hold our fibers as best we can to start with, and I'm just going to move this in so perhaps we can get a better shot. And you're just going to touch, I'm going to bend the foot up roughly at the ankle, and you're just going to touch to the wax and scrape it off a little bit. Okay, so it's a very light covering. And then we're going to wait, which is always the part that I have trouble with, because I just want to get my fingers in there. But if you do, it will create a massive mess. Just need to give the wax a few seconds. And then just rub it with your finger. Top to bottom, front to back. Don't, you know, go in circles or scrub it side to side. Follow the fibers and just, you're just working the wax into the fibers. On the bottom of your little foot. It's a huge mess to start with, but it gets better. And then using the residual wax on your fingers, just twist a bit up the stem. Okay, so we've kind of got the foot bent this way, which means it's very hard to dunk it. So we're going to wax pot back in. We're going to use our spatula. I'm just going to take some of this wax, just apply it on the top. Not very much. You can always add more. Just a few drops. Let it do its thing. And then just start rubbing it in with your finger. Starting to take shape. And the kind of bulbousness of some of the wool is creating natural veins and thing in the foot that we can utilize. So I'm just going to put a bit more wax on, push it in with the spatula a little bit. And don't be worried about all of this white, that will all go in time. Work it in. This is probably one of my most favourite things to do. A legitimate reason to be absolutely messy and sticky. Okay, so we have a little waxed foot. You just use your fingers just to rub off some of the surplus wax. There we go. Okay, so we have something that's really starting to come together. This is just the first application of wax. but in order for it to be even more realistic, we want to do some contouring and some shaping. So if you grab your pliers, I find that this is generally a good time to give your the underside of your foot some definition with the claw shapes. So get your pliers about halfway up the toe and just bend it ever so slightly. And then just use your pliers to manipulate them a little bit. Don't panic if you indent your wax or anything like that. So, like that. And if you see now, we've got a bit of a curve to the toes, which make them look a little more natural. Like that. I generally start with the underneath of the foot first. I know a lot of people won't necessarily pick up your creation to look at the underside of their feet, but I like to do a little bit of contouring on the underside of the foot. We're going to get our sculpting tool. And if you sort of look at your hand, you see that you've got areas where there are sort of more bulbous bits. And that's what we're going to try and create on here. You can attempt to be as anatomically correct as a real rat foot. I just tend to put in some shapes. With this being metal, I'm going to use the little flat but rounded end of this particular one. And this wax is, although it's still soft and pliable, it's starting to set. So I'm just going to touch my tool to the hot plate on my melter just for a few seconds, and then I'm going to push it into the wax, and it will just re-melt the wax, and you can make a nice sort of central foot indentation, and then scrape away any excess white. So you see we've got a nice contour going on there straight away. I tend to put in a contour here and then one here. So let's just wipe that off. Touch for a few seconds. Push in. So it's just a little bit of sculpting. You can use the very, very end to, you know, make a more defined ridge. Smooth it out with your hands a little. And if you put a great big line somewhere you don't like, it's very, very simple to change it. You know, you just flow a little more wax in there, remelt it, whatever you want to do. No hard and fast rules with this. It's just play it by ear and see what develops. I like to just press in underneath the toes to give that sort of ball of the foot. Let me get my nail out of the way. You might be able to see better. There. Just touch and press under the toes. See how that's starting to come together. Bring it between the toes. This is when you can spend as much or as little time as you want, just fiddling with sculpting the little shapes and contours that you want in your foot. There. I'm actually concentrating so much on what I'm doing, I'm not actually watching whether or not it's on the camera, so I hope that all just came out on the shot okay. So this is now quite solid underneath here, so the working of it is getting a bit more difficult. You can apply some gentle heat to it. A hairdryer, for example, will just soften the wax. Don't hold it too close, but if you want some more working time with your wax here, then you know, just heat it up a little bit. Now we're going to pay some attention to the top, because the bottom's now looking quite nice. This is where my OCD won't let me have little white bits under here, so let me just get those. There we go. Okay, the top is pretty much the same as the bottom. Again, look at your hand, look at pictures on the internet of ratty feet. You know, you're going to have some kind of tendons and stuff going up the foot. So I'm going to start by using the sort of slicey end of this particular tool. I'm just going to touch my hot plate and just mark in roughly where the toes would sort of lead up. And then go back to my contouring. Let's see if I can get the light a little better. Should show up okay. So again, in between the toes, just start molding and shaping the heat from a sculpting tool will certainly help cut into wax that's already set. And then scrape off anything that's excess. There we go. You can see you can get some real nice contouring on the toes. Just carve a little bit of that off the side there. So there, that's in a nutshell how we get some contouring. If you find that you're contouring and you are digging up fibers, then you need to apply a little more wax. The trick with the wax is not to apply a lot at once, it's to apply it in layers and spend, you know, as much time as you like just fiddling and getting your contours. I've got some white that I will be getting rid of, but I will show you that after we've done the back foot. So there you go. For just a few minutes, you can turn something that you've waxed into something that looks very skin-like and realistic just by spending a few minutes contouring. Okay, so I will go and clean my hands off to do the next foot, and we'll be back with the back foot. I've moved my setup slightly so that you can see the dipping process. Hopefully this won't solidify in the time that I'm doing this. So we're going to do a back foot. Again, we're starting with the toes, so a very small amount of wool. Hold the end on what would be, I suppose, the ankle. Just wrap it around once. Or twice. Okay, so we'll start with this little toe down here. So bring it up. And remember, we're wrapping flat. So wrap it around. Wrap it around. Then we have this little bit of wire stuck out here that we are just going to touch into the wax so that it can grab our next wrap. Oh, and mine just unraveled. What I'm trying to do is work around. There we go. There. So let's hold that off to one side. So we've got our little toe, and then we're going to dip. See if I can move that a little better. I'm going to just dip about that much. I've caught the other toe as well, but that doesn't matter. And then work it into the tip and up the toe. Need a little more on that one. And I really am pinching quite tightly, as I said before. Not pushing too hard that way, but the pinch to work the wax into the wall is quite tight. And again, if you don't have enough, just apply a little bit more. This is solidifying on me. Just pop that back on the melter. So you really are just touching the very, very tip when you're doing the initial wrap. And then you're only dipping maybe that bottom third into the wax, which you're then working all the way up the toe. It takes a little bit of practice. Like I said, it is fiddly. I think I might have enough on here to do another toe. So let's work that around again to the tip. Just a little bit to grab as we work back down. Let's move this camera angle again now so I can hold this in shot. And then we're going to dunk that much. Work it in all the way up. It's always useful to hold on to this end as well. Otherwise, when you're twisting this, this starts getting a bit wild. There we go. The next toe. Just going to take this around the stem. Oops. Another bit. And this will be toe number three. So again, just hold it very gently at the ankle. Once around, up to the toe. Move your other toes out of the way. Oops. Almost to the end. And then you dip. Might have enough to do this one. Okay, take that down out of the way. Camera angle is shocking on this, I'm afraid. I'm trying to get the waxing and the dipping in the same shot and it's not working for the close-up, so I apologise if most of that was just off of shot. Okay, two more to do. Another section of wall. The more you do this, the more you will get a feel for how much wool to use. Move that tip out of the way. And then we just... Oops. Dip the very tip. Let that grab the wool. Work it back. Dip a little more. And rub it in. And again, you always twist your wax into the wool the same way that you wrap. Otherwise, you will end up with a very, very big mess. Down the stem. Last toe. Once around the ankle. Dip the tip, just to grab, back down the little toe, then we're going to dip the toe. Out of the way. So I hope most of that got caught on camera. So there we have our five toes. Bring the loose bit down. Just wrap it tightly around the stem. Okay, maneuver the toes. If you remember earlier, I said the back feet, you need to have one right hand and one left hand foot. I hope that made sense. This little claw that's right down low goes on the inside of the rat foot, so it's like your thumbs. So you have one this way and one this way. This is determined by which way you bend the stem. So if I bend the stem up like that with the claw on this side, then that makes it a left foot. But if I bend it, if I turn it over and bend it up, then it's a right foot. This will not matter until you come to decide which is going to be the underside of your foot. So whichever one you make now, you must do the opposite later. All the toes are done. So now we are just going to build up and cover all of these sort of bits of wire that are now still showing. So once around the ankle, through there. There's no exact route. And then just wind it back down to the stem. Now, this being a back foot, let me get my little demo bunny or demo rat. The back foot is significantly longer here than the front, so we're going to do a little bit of extra building up around this area here. Get a bit more wool. Once around the ankle and pull that tight. And then we're going to have that there. Work it back down the stem. So this is going to be a right hand or a right foot. This is going to be the underside. This is going to be the top. What we're going to do finally is just lay that wool over the top through the toes, so we have that directionality in the skin or fur. So again, we don't want anything too thick, but we do want quite wide. See if I can do a better job of it this time than I did last time. So just popping toes. Through, like so. And then the heel is where that bulbous bit is. So we're just going to bend so I know which way round this is going to go. And then just twist it around your stem a little bit just to hold it while we're working the foot. I'm just going to get my little hot mat back and put this there so you can see this dip. Focus. There we go. So this is going to be the underside, and I'm literally just touching it to the wax. Scrape that off. And do remember that the tea light case is going to be very, very hot. Give it a second to just not be quite so severe to your fingers, and then just start brushing it top to bottom, or toes to heel. You're just working that wax into the bottom of the ball. I've got nails as well, so I tend to use that to push. You could use your spatula to get a little bit of wax on it. You can use that to help work it in. You'll develop tools and techniques for the way that you like to work. Like I said, there is no wrong way of doing this. There's just what works best for you. Spatula is good for getting wax in between the toes. So once you've got the wax on the bottom, then we need to turn our attention to the top. So with the spatula, I'm just going to leave that in the wax a second to melt off some of the excess wax that's built up on my spatula. Right, cue the mess. Just a few scoops, just dropping it on. Start rubbing it in. The wool will compress as you're working it in with the wax as well. It kind of solidifies in between the fibres, so as you're pushing down, the wool is becoming compressed. Work all the way around. The wax back in the pot. Get a little bit more on my spatula. Got some here. And just check in between your toes. You know, you can still move these around. The wax is still at a workable temperature, very malleable temperature. We're not aiming for smooth and perfect, we are aiming for quite gnarly. Okay, so toe bending time. This is going to be a right foot, so this is the bottom and this is the top. So we're going to lift, see if I can get a close up. So with this toe, right at the top of the toe, we're kind of going up a bit and then from halfway bend it over. And then you can see, so the next toe, we kind of lift it up a little bit at the bottom, rather at the top of the toe, and then bend it over. So, up by the foot, and then bent over at the end. And bent over. And then this little inner claw, just bend it. And see, completely messed up the wax. Not a problem. Just work it back in. And if need be, give it another little dip. That little claw. It's very, very forgiving. Okay, so we've got waxed and curled toes. Now we need to do a little bit of contouring. Again, I'm going to start with the bottom. Sometimes the wool will almost give you contours. You see you've got a almost like a wave going through the foot there, so I'm going to work with that. I'll go in and follow it with my little tool. We need to make sure that we form the heel, so just work out roughly where the back of the foot is going to be. And then just go in and make your mark. And if you don't like it, then, you know, just rub it out and change it. Heat up the wax again. Okay, so let's go in and do some contouring. A bit of an indentation here. I'm going to go in underneath my toes and create the ball of my foot. Like that. And again, you can spend as much time or as little time as you want on doing your contouring. There's no hard and fast rules. Okay, well this tutorial is dragging on somewhat, so we'll speed this up a little bit and I will come back and do some more contouring later on the bottom. So just on the top again, you want to almost create sort of tendons and folds. Just draw in your initial lines. So you can see rub it in with your fingers and then start creating your contours. You can pinch the tips down a little bit more, create a little bit more of a claw-like end. There we go. This one's a little crude, but you get the idea. Any build-up of real kind of white sort of crumply bits of wax that you have left on your project, pick off what you can, blend in what you can. If you absolutely need to remelt it, then just apply a hairdryer from a distance. You'll find that it will melt it quite easily. But there you have, so this one's a little crude, but time is of the essence. I have absolutely no idea how long this has been going on. So there we go. One front foot, one back foot. Waxed and wrapped and contoured. So have fun with it, guys. You can apply this principle to all kinds of different feet. You can do it for hands, beaks. You know, the sky is the limit. Do let me know how you get on. I would be very interested to see your results. And have fun waxing.